All right, section 7.1, sequences. We're on example 6. We're going to be writing explicit formulas for a couple of sequences. All right, let's look at this one. Each time we look at a sequence, we mostly want to figure out if something's adding to change the numbers or multiplying to change the numbers. So this one here looks more like an adding problem. So if we're going from negative 6 to negative 1, that would be adding 5. Negative 1 to 4, adding 5 again, and then 4 to 9 would be adding 5 again, correct? So let's write an explicit formula for that. This is obviously an arithmetic sequence. And our common difference is 5. We can use the formula that we talked about earlier. I don't like depending on whether I've memorized that formula correctly or not. I can't remember, was that formula on our formula sheet? I can't think above it at this point. But I will check in a few minutes. Okay, so anyway, so since 5 is our common difference, we can do 5 times n, right? But then we have our starting term, which is a negative 6. And we have to go backwards 5 from that. So we're going to subtract our common difference 5 from that. I think this does come from the formula I told you about earlier, which was I think a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times our common difference d, right? So if we plug a 5 in here and we distribute that through, we end up with 5n minus 5, and this was 6. Oh, that's a negative 6. So then we have 5n and negative 11. That does sound correct. So a sub n should be 5n minus 11. And it's arithmetic. And that should give us any term that we want to find. Okay, this one, when I see the fractions, that immediately makes me think that it's probably a ratio that's happening here. So to find our ratio, we can take a term and divide a previous term. That's a good way to find a ratio. And if you want to check and make sure that they are all that same ratio, just go down to the next term and do the same thing. Go down to the next term and do the same thing. So that's how we can test to make sure it's geometric. So like if we have 10/3 and we divide by negative 5 goes into 10 twice. So it would be negative 2 because of the negative. So that gives us a negative 2/3. Let's try the next one up. So negative 20 over 9 divided by 10/3. So that's the same thing as negative 20 over 9 times 3/10. Right? So 10 would go into 20. And then we have 3 would go into 9 as well. So let's do this. Negative 6/9, and then that reduces further to negative 2/3. Look how we got the same ratio. Would this one work as well? I would hope so. So 40/27 divided by negative 29. So it's the same thing as 40 over 27 times 9 over negative 20. And then dividing appropriately. So 40, negative 20 goes into 40 twice, negative 2 times 9, and then that's over 27. So that would be negative 18/27, which is in fact negative 2/3. I probably didn't need to go to all that effort to figure out that it's geometric. Right? But I did prove it here that that is the R value because it worked every time. Okay, just to give myself some space here, let's get rid of all of this verification work. And let's go ahead and do our explicit formula. Now, these are super easy. A sub n equals a sub 1 times r to the n minus 1 power, right? That's it. So a sub n equals, we're going to replace a sub 1 with a number, in this case, a negative 5. And then we replace r with a number, in this case, a negative 2/3. And then that number is to the to the n minus 1 power. I don't know if we specifically, we probably don't need this little parenthesis right in there. It doesn't hurt anything, but If we leave it like that, then that makes it more obvious. First term, common ratio, got our power to make this work right. We should be able to plug in any n value and get that number of the sequence. Okay, let's keep going on that theme. Only this gives us a little bit different information. So in the two problems we just did, they actually gave us the actual sequence, and we used that to figure out whether it was arithmetic or geometric, find the common difference, find the common ratio, use those values to find the equations, right? This time we're given a little bit different stuff. So the first term of an arithmetic sequence is 15, and the 10th term is negative 12. Find the common difference and the explicit formula. So the way that I like to do these is to remember that that common difference is a lot like a slope. So if you remember how to find slope by doing the difference between the y values for the rise and the difference between the x values for the run, that's a really easy way to find that value. There is another way we can do it though, just by plugging in a set of both sets of numbers and seeing what works. So we have a sub n, we could say that n equals 10. So for a sub n, I'm plugging in the y value, the negative 12, that's the number in the sequence. And then for a sub 1, I plug in the value when n equals 1, which is 15. And then I do 10 minus 1 because that's the 10th term, so n minus 1. And then that's times d, and we don't know what d is. But now at this point, since we plugged in that point, we can use the equation to solve for d, which is a negative 3. So another way to do this same problem, so this is just an alternative, is to use a slope alternate. So slope would be like where you go y minus y over x minus x. So our y value is negative 12 minus 15, and the x value would be 10 minus 1. So that would give us negative 27 over 9, which is also negative 3. Like I got the same number by doing it that way. So whatever's easiest, you're just trying to figure out how much it changes each time it changes to the next term, right? So if it's jumping 10 terms, it's not actually jumping 10 terms, it's jumping 9 terms because it's going from the first term to the 10th term. How much is the overall jump from the first term to the 10th term? And then divide that by 9 jumps to find that value. Okay, so to write our equation, we now plug in our first term. We plug in our common difference. I like to put parentheses around this right here. And we distribute that through, so that gives us negative 3n, and then a negative 3 times a negative 1 is a positive 3. Add our 15 and 3 together because our first term is 15. We have to add 3 to that so that we start at 18. So that for our first number, when we subtract 3, it gives us 15. If we don't add that extra 3 in there, then we just keep it at 15, like our y-intercept. Remember, that's where n equals 1. That's not where n equals 0. We have to have that number be high enough so that when we start taking our minus 3 from each term, we start the right place. So 18 minus 3 is 15. That's where we start. And then 15 minus 3 would be 12, etc., going down to the 10th term of negative 12 and beyond. So that's our answer right there. That's one way of writing our answers in that notation with our little curly brackets. We could say where we're starting and ending. It would just be like n equals 1 to infinity, right? But if those aren't written, they're just implied. Okay, let's try this one. The first term of an arithmetic sequence is negative 12. So first term, negative 12. Its common difference is 5. Which term of this sequence has a value of 58? Well, I think writing the formula would be helpful, right? So let's find the explicit formula first. So to do that, I already have d. I'm just going to use my formula. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So that's going to give me, I don't know why I wrote the d value in and I didn't write anything else in. Just writing down the formula. Okay, so a sub 1 was negative 12. So negative 12 plus 5n minus 5 So that'll be 5n minus 17. So there's the formula we can use. So now we want to figure out which value is going to equal 58. So let's go ahead and solve this. 5n is going to equal 58 plus 17. 7 plus 8 is 15. So 75, does that sound right? Then divide both sides by 5. So n would equal 15. So the 15th term should be 58. If you want to check that, you could always say, okay, I'm adding 5. So negative 12 plus 5 plus 5. You wouldn't be adding it 15 times, you'd be adding it 14 times because you start at the first number. So to get to the 15th number, you would be adding it 14 times. So we really could shorten that by saying we're adding it 14 times. So start at negative 12, add this 14 times, and sure enough, that gives us a 58. So that works. I just checked my answer by plugging it back in, making sure it worked out. Cool. So the 15th term is 58. Here's a couple more examples where I've used that slope formula again, taken my points, turned them into points, and used that change in formula. I'm going to do a separate video for this though, because my one I'm working on right now is almost 12 minutes.